Okay, so let's solve this problem. So given this probability distribution and to find the mean, the variance, and the standard deviation using this long method. So first, we need to supply all the unknown columns. And for this column, so we need to multiply this x and the p of x. So multiply this 1 times 1 over 7. So this is 1 over 7. Then 3 times 3 over 7. So just multiply this 3 times 3. So we have 9 and copy the denominator 7. Then 5 times 2 over 7. So we have 5 times 2. That's 10. Then over 7. And 7 times 1 over 7. So 7 times 1, that's 7, then over 7. Then we need to find the summation of x times the p of x. So just add all these numbers. Since we have the same denominators, so just copy. So this is 7, then add the numerators. So 1 plus 9, that's 10, plus 10, this one is 20, plus 7, so that's 27, so that's 27 over 7, and convert this one to decimal, so 27 divided by 7 equals, so we have 3.8571, so this is equal to 3.8571. 71, and this is now the mean of the distribution. So for this column, and that's the mean, so this is 3.8571. So 3.8571, 3.8571, and 3.8571. And to solve now for this column, so we have x minus the mean. So x minus the mean, so we have 1 minus this 3.8571, so this is negative 2.8571. Then for this 3 minus 3.8571, that's negative 0.8571. And 5 minus 3.8571, so we have 5 minus 3.8571 equals, so positive 1.1429. So this is positive 1.1429. And the last one, 7 minus 3.8571. So 7 minus 3.8571, so that's 3.1429, so positive 3.1429. Then we can solve now this column, so just take the square of this column, so the square of negative 2.8571. So since we're taking the square, so we can just ignore this negative. So we have now 2.8571, then take the square, so you can ignore the negative. So that's 8.1630. So this is 8.16, then 30. And for this row, so we have 0.8571, then square. So that's 0.7346. So 0.7346. Then for this row, so we have 1.1429, then square. 1.3062. So this is 1.30, then 62. And for the last one, so 3.1429, then square. So it's 9.8778. So this is 9.8778. Then for this last column, so just multiply this x minus the mean squared and the p of x. So again, we need to multiply these two columns. So just multiply the numerator and divide by 7. So we have 1 times 8.1630. So 1 times 8.1630, so the same as 8.1630. Then divide by 7, so divide by this denominator. It's 1.1661. So this is 1.1661. Then for this row, so this 3 times this 0.7346. So we have 3 times 0.7346 equals, then divide by 7. So that's 0.3148. So 0.3148. And for this 2 times 1.3062. So 2 times 1.3062 equals, then divide by 7. So that's 0.3732. So 0.3732. Then the last row, so 1 times 9.8778. So 1 times 9.8778, so that's 9.8778. Then divide by 7. That's 1.4111. So 1.4111. Then this time, we can find now the summation of x minus the mean squared times the p of x. So just add all these numbers. So we have 1.1661 plus 0.3148 plus 0.3732 plus 1.4111 equals, so we have 3.2652. So this is 3.2652. And this is now the variance of this distribution. Then to find out the standard deviation, so just take the square root of the variance. So we have now the square root of 3.2652. So therefore, the standard deviation, so we have the square root of 3.2652 equals 1.8070. So this is 1.8070. So this is how to find the mean, the variance, and the standard deviation using this long method. And to solve for this problem using this short method, so this is the table. So again, we need to supply all the unknown columns. So for this column, so multiply this x and the p of x. So 1 times 1 over 7, this is 1 over 7. 3 times 3 over 7, so 3 times 3, that's 9, then over 7. 5 times 2 over 7, this one is 10 over 7. And 7 times 1 over 7, this is 7 over 7. Then find the summation of x times the p of x. So this is 27 over 7, then in decimal. So 27 divided by 7, so that's 3.8571. So we have 3.8571, and this is the mean. Then for this column, so just take the square of x. So the square of 1, that's 1 times 1, this is 1. the square of 3, so 3 times 3, that's 9. The square of 5, so 5 times 5, this one is 25. And the square of 7, this is 7 times 7, so we have 49. Then for this column, so multiply this x squared and the p of x. So we need to multiply these two columns. So this 1 over 7 times 1. So that's 1 over 7 and in decimal. So 1 divided by 7, that's 0.1429. So this is 0.1429. Then for this 3 over 7 times 9, so 3 times 9, that's 27. So we have 3 times 9, that's 27, then divide by 7, so that's 3.8571. So this is 3.8571. Then for this 2 times 25, so that's 50, and 50 divided by 7, so 2 times 25, 50 divided by 7, so that's 7.1429, so 7.14, then 29. Then for this 1 times 49, that's 49, then divide by 7. So 49 divided by 7, this one is 7. So this is 7. Then to find now the summation of x squared times the p of x. So add all these numbers. So we have 0.1429 plus 3.8571 plus 7.1429. Then plus 7, so that's 18.1429. So this is 18.14, then 29. Then this time, to find now the variance, so using this formula, so we have the summation of x squared times the p of x, so this is x squared times the p of x, and that's 18.49. So this is 18.1429, then minus the summation of x times the p of x, and x times the p of x, that's the mean. So 3.8571, then take the squared. So the variance. So to solve now for the variance, we have 18.1429, then minus this 3.8571, then squared, equals so 3.2657. So the variance is 3.2657. And to solve now for the standard deviation, so just the square root of the variance. So the square root of 3.2657. So we have the square root of 3.2657. That's 1.871. So 1.871. So these are the two methods in solving for the mean, variance, and standard deviation for this probability distribution.